Well, it's been almost 3 years now, and I'm very happy to report that Unifi has finally put auto tracking in the PTZ. I'm gonna jump in real quick and show you the feature, how it works, what I like about it, what I don't like about it, and mention some other things that I think that Unifi needs to keep working on to make this product actually even better still. So let's jump right in, and I'm gonna show you a little bit of the setup of the camera. So if I click on the camera, in here, it looks very similar to what it looked like before. It does have one extra feature here where you can set up where your home view is. So if I wanted to edit that, I could move the camera around and reset where home is. I'm not gonna do that. And you can share a live stream. There's advanced, which is basically just some of your resolution stuff, and restart. I've got it set to record always on continuous. It's on motion detection, smart detection, and those detections are for recording detections. That's person and vehicle, but that's not necessarily for tracking. Then I've got my detection record settings. Got it for 1 second for motion detection and a couple seconds for the others. And you can see you've got frame rate. Basically, very similar stuff to the other cameras. So there's not much new in here other than we've got the home screen setting there. As you can see here, I've got several cameras in our parking lot, and I'm gonna fire up the PTZ. This is the only one that is a PTZ. As you can see, I can zoom in and out. I can do all the things I could originally do with the PTZ in my original review. But in here, you'll notice there is one extra item in the icon list, and then I can turn on auto tracking. As you can see, Michael's walking into the frame. It almost immediately picks him up. It will track him wherever he goes. Sometimes it's a little, you know, it doesn't do it completely smoothly, but I think it really does a quite nice job. In live view, there is a little bit of pixelation, but if I go back or download or watch the detection, it will look much better than it does in actual live view. But it's really still a great image. You can tell that that's Michael. You can see where he's going. You can see all those things. It also tracks it beyond its motion detection zone. So I have a motion detection zone that excludes the cars that are going by. So you can see he's back there beyond where that detection zone is. It will still follow him through that detection zone. Follows him pretty steadily. It will zoom in and out a little bit based upon, you know, where he is in the frame, which is great. You'll see now he's lost detection. See when it kicks him back up again. I see it picks him back up again, and it realizes he's getting close in the frame, and it goes wide again. When it is done, it will, and when he comes back in the office, it will, after maybe 2 or 3 seconds, it will, maybe it's 4 or 5 seconds, it will then recenter itself. Maybe it's 10 seconds, and you see it recenters itself. I will tell you, and I'll give Ubiquiti a little bit of a pass, sometimes it sticks on returning to home. So every once in a while, you'll come in and you'll see that this camera is pointed in the wrong direction, which obviously isn't ideal. It's early days on this feature, so I'll give them a little bit of some breathing room there. I think it works 95% of the time. It works really well. Okay, now you can see that I have two people in the screen, and it's gonna prioritize one of the two people. Obviously, it can't search, can't roam on both people at the same time. So I think what it's doing is the bigger one, the more predominant one that's closer to the lens is the one it's prioritizing on. So you can see it followed Michael and not Houston there. But obviously, you know, it's just one camera. It can't, you know, can't defy the laws of physics. So that's basically what happens when you have two people in frame and it's looking at two people. Another thing you may ask is, does it follow vehicles? It does not follow vehicles. At this point, it may be something I could set up or it may be able to do in the future. But at this point, it just follows humans as they come in and out of their cars. Like I said in my original review, it's a really nice piece of hardware. Some things that I think that Ubiquiti still needs to keep working on with this. I think it really should have patrolling, meaning that you can just automatically at an interval look left and right here. So the pan that it did on Michael, there's a parking lot next to us. It might be nice to every once in a while get a view of what's going on in that parking lot. Another thing that might be nice is actual face detection. I know the hardware in this one probably won't ever support face detection, but it would be a nice feature for an upgrade. You know, at $1,800, I would expect that it might have those kind of features. Along the same lines as the facial recognition is license plate detection. I think it's well within the capabilities of the optics of this camera to do license plate detection, but I don't know if it's got the hardware inside of the camera itself to be able to pull that off. One other thing I would like to see added to the Unifi Protect software, and this really goes for all cameras, is object removal. so that if there's something that I want to make sure isn't moved or stolen, that it would alert you if that object was moved. Obviously, I'm a little tongue-in-cheek when I say it's been 2.5 years and they just added this feature, but I really do appreciate the fact that Unifi isn't orphaning this project, and obviously there's development going forward. So let me know in the comments below whether this is a camera that even interests anybody, or if you have the camera, what have your experiences been? If you like this kind of video, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.